Hey, what's going on? It's your boy George. G-Works Lee Auto Finish. Never ride dirty. Book it down Bronx. You already know. So today we have a Chrysler minivan. We're going to be doing an engine detail. Pretty dirty. We have some red droppings there. So I may not do a video on the whole process because we got to get this done. While I do the engine detail, my wife is doing the interior. I'll show you guys the inside. So basically this brush here is a really, really good brush for cleaning leather. You know, I have another one that we use for cleaning the carpets and stuff like that. We gotta get that all cleaned up. So. So we got some work to do right now. Oh, and the rims. Show you guys the rims. There you go. And it's dirty. All right, let's get busy. So basically what I'll do here is an older vehicle. I'll be covering this part here. And I'll put a bag over the alternator and we'll get started. Oh, and before I forget, I'll let the engine cool down a little because he did just show up and stuff, and I don't want to spray my degreaser on the engine and then it just evaporates because the heat of the engine compartment or the engine itself. So I'll let that cool down for a little bit. So I'll back it up, let you guys see. I do all the YouTube videos. Yeah, so.
Well, put it on, man.
You want to be on the camera?
Yeah, shit, man. Hold on. So,
there we go. So what you, I know you were telling me that you were hoping we were out here today.
Yes, I did.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah. I don't trust nobody else.
Thanks a lot. Really appreciate it. So, you know, I know you lost our number, so I gave you the flyer and stuff like that.
Well, I got it now.
But he told me, listen, if they're not out here, I'm not doing my car.
Nope.
We're going to take care of it.
I don't let nobody else touch my car.
Get that leather nice and cleaned and conditioned. And.
Well, she comes out of here with flying colors.
Thank you. Appreciate it. So, yeah, this is not a customer of mine. This is a client.
A good friend
also. So yeah. Every time he comes, he never gets a bullshit service. He's always
number one.
I won't say any service is bullshit. Let me rephrase that. But he always gets what we call one of our full details.
There you go.
That when he comes and pulls up, it's he wants to work.
I'm the old Goldie. The old Goldie and a USM Marine.
There we go. Let's get you got that Marine hat there. That's right. All right, let me pause it. What was that?
In the Marines, they say you only go to the best, and this is the best.
Thank you. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Well, that's one of the sayings that I put on my Facebook account and stuff like that.
Beautiful.
You know, same phrase he used. My phrase was, you tried the rest, now come try the best.
There it is. And the best is the only one.
The only one. I'm letting that engine cool down. This way we can start it.
Oh, yeah. Because I only drove from here to there.
All right.
I didn't go for a long distance.
Yeah. Just a little bit. This way, when I spray that degreaser, it doesn't...
I'm in no rush.
All right.
Hook it up. Put it in. What do you need? 12 volts?
Yeah. So here we go. I got my super degreaser here and my pump sprayer. Not bad at all. So I have my super clean.
Oh my God, every time you watch it, it went out of battery.
And so basically, let me change the tip here, the spray pattern. So basically, you want to start from the top. So one thing I'm going to do is, it's kind of, it's warmer than the other day. So I'm going to take the fenders and I'm just going to wet them. You know, this way we don't get no stains on the paint, potential stains, just in case. Always practice risk management. So there we go, I have a coating of that being wet. We'll spray the light. Let me pause this, get this knife. All right, so what I'm just doing is making sure that, because it is hot out here. And I don't want the nozzle, I mean the paint, getting potentially stained from the degreaser. So we'll wet it. This way the surface is not dry. There we go. Now I come, like I said, we start from the top. So once again, this is super clean. So we get the firewall. That's why I love this thing here. You know, we get to go all the way into the firewall. Instead of using a spray bottle, we'll get the drink reservoir. You know, so I'm gonna cut the camera for now and get this thing all soaked up with the super clean. So right now, my client's showing me a thing he uses to boost cars, right? That's what it is. It's a little gadget.
And a charger.
You could charge it. Yep. Well, 12 volt charger.
And you got light.
Has flashlight. And here goes the other piece to boosting cables. He said he gave about 8 people boosts already. Huh?
Yeah, that car is charging.
Look at that. And it's not even a big booster pack.
Yeah. All you need is 12 volts to turn the car on.
Nice.
Unless you got a rotten battery.
Yeah. Let me get this degreaser off now. So basically that thing there, he says you could charge it in your car through the cigarette lighter port.
Cigarette lighter.
Huh. And they can find out where they can find that at?
Either Best Buy or... Well, usually Best Buy has it right now.
Best Buy.
Yeah.
So you can find that booster pack in Best Buy. It takes no space. And you can charge it in your cigarette lighter port. So basically... We got the surface clean. I'm gonna touch up some spots here, right under here. I'm gonna hit that up, all right? So here I'm using, get that spot here. What was that? All right. It's the only thing, you know, I get a lot of attention here where, you know, everybody wants to stop and ask and talk. And, you know, it's not a bad thing because, you know, that means we're being recognized and, or they want to figure out, you know, what is it that we charge. But for the most part, sometimes when you're trying to get certain jobs done, you know, and in this case, we have like this grease on here where we don't want to just dry up. Well, you know what? Me saying that, let me get the foam thing. So basically, here we go. We'll do that so it doesn't dry up. Makes sense, huh? So this way we can hit that area. There we go. See? I had another one of my moments. But like I said, duh! We don't want it drying up so we can hit that area right between there. So now I take my brush and now I can agitate the surface. And this brush is pretty cool because it's stiff, where I can get all these areas and it actually gets everything out. Here we go. So for example, I get right between here. Let me check it out. Yeah, there we go. Look at this part. And there we go, it's clean. Now it's ready for rinsing. All right, pause this and turn this on. So now basically I'll take my leaf blower. Guys, get the idea of what I'm gonna be doing with the leaf blower. Just a regular leaf blower to dry the engine compartment. All right, I'll put it on pause. So right as of right now, I just finished the engine wash. My wife's still doing the inside. Then we'll get to the.
I just came out of the plant. Hey.
Right?
Good.
Huh?
With the hood open to the
plant. With the hood open?
Good.
There we go. Those marks from when the hood gets closed. Wasn't dirt. But yeah, there you go. engine wash complete. Reservoir, the brake reservoir, nice and cleaned and dressed. The hoses, cleaned and dressed. Everything done. And that was using Super Clean. Degreaser diluted 10 to 1. Once again, I have my Super Clean, and I'm gonna be throwing the wheel wells. It's the Super Clean. There we go. Alright, so there we go. We sprayed the whole thing. Right there. Really just getting the fenders so that sprayed some more grease on the wheel well, so whatever splattered on the fenders, I don't want that drying up since it's hot outside. So we wet that fender all up, make sure that stays nice and moist and wet. So right now I have my foam cannon already made up with my pink soap. 2 ounces of pink soap in the foam cannon. So that's ready to go. Foam, baby, foam! She almost got me! She almost got me! two ounces of pink soap in the foam cannon. Oh,